What types of assets should I put in my trust? You know, this is a question I get a lot from my clients. So a lot of high net worth individuals decide to set up a trust or foundation with certain assets in mind. Either business interests they want to transfer to it, or investments, or valuable collectibles like cars or art or valuable personal assets. And so you start planning the trust with those things in mind, but once you get down the road a little bit in the planning process and they get their trust set up, they're excited to use it and they want to know what all they can transfer into their trust, which is understandable. They spent a lot of time and effort and money setting this thing up. They want to maximize its benefits. So what can I transfer to my trust? The question shouldn't be what I can transfer to my trust. The question should be, what should I transfer to my trust? Not all assets should be transferred to your trust. So in this video, we're going to be analyzing what assets you should transfer to your trust and which ones you should not. Let's get started. First off, before we get too deep into what types of assets we should and should not be transferring to our trust, let's just go over trust basics really quick. I'm just going to run through this really fast. If you want a more in-depth analysis on what trusts are and how they work, check out my introduction to trust video. The link is down in the description. So, a trust is formed when a settlor is the person that transfers assets into the trust, transfers assets to the trustee. The trustee is the person who's going to hold legal title to those assets, who's going to own them and administer them in accordance with the trust agreement for the benefit of the beneficiaries, who are the people who are going to benefit from the trust. You also have the option of having a protector, and the protector generally has certain powers, like keeping an eye on the trustee and removing and replacing them if they're not doing their job, approving amendments and distributions, things like that. So there's your trust basics. Now let's look at what assets you should transfer into your trust. If you like our content, please don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking that subscribe button. We'd really appreciate it. And for more strategic tips on international tax and wealth planning, subscribe to our email list and follow me on LinkedIn. Links below. Just examples, but basically what you want to put in your trust are investments. And I say investments broadly, right? These can be interests in companies that own privately operated businesses. It can be portfolios. It can be collectible assets. It can be all kinds of things. So for example, bank accounts. And I'm not talking about your checking account. I'm talking about bank accounts like savings accounts and brokerage accounts, CDs, shares in privately held companies, partnership interests, LLC interests, crypto, safety deposit boxes, investments in business and real estate, life insurance, like I said, valuable personal property like jewelry, art, antiques, collectible vehicles, and other valuable assets. Couple things to keep in mind, and that's where we're going to talk about caution. This is where you need to beware. So first of all, you need to be aware of transferring personal assets, meaning assets that you use personally, to the trust. These are things like your home, for example, or a vacation home, because depending on how your trust is structured and where you're a citizen and a resident, if a trust owns assets that you use personally, the value of using those assets could be attributable to you as income and subject to tax. So that's something we need to look at, obviously, in your particular situation, but I'm just saying here in general, be aware of transferring assets that you use personally into the trust. There could be tax consequences. Secondly, you should generally avoid assets being owned directly by your trust. So for example, you don't want to form a trust and then have that trust own, for example, your brokerage account, different investments, your collectibles, business interests, rental properties, stuff like this, because what happens if the trust gets sued? If the trust gets sued for any kind of liability related to any of those assets, all of those assets are going to be at risk because they're all owned by the trust. So it's much better to take different assets or different asset classes and have them owned by companies that are owned by the trust. So you might have one company that owns each rental property. You might have another company that owns your liquid investments, another company that owns collectibles or different classes of collectibles. So this way, all the trust owns is interests in different companies, and those companies own the various assets or asset classes. This is the way you're siloing the risk or potential liabilities within each one of those companies and limiting the liability to the assets contained in that company. So let's say, for example, like I said, your trust owns rental properties, and each rental property is in a separate company owned by the trust. If there's liability with regard to one of those properties, and the company owning that property gets sued, the only thing at risk is the asset that is in that one company. Everything else is protected. To recap, be careful of transferring assets you use personally to the trust. There could be tax consequences, and generally try to avoid assets being owned directly by your trust. Have them owned indirectly through companies owned by the trust. Now let's talk about what you should not transfer to your trust. And this is basically high risk assets. Assets where liability is likely to be attached to them. This is vehicles, for example, right? Car accidents, stuff like that. Vehicles can be a huge source of liability. And even with insurance, what happens if the liability is in excess of the insurance? If it was in the trust, then the trust may be liable for this. So don't put your cars in a trust. And depending on, like I said, how your trust is structured, be aware of putting personal use assets in there. And also be aware that some assets, like certain types of annuities and retirement accounts, actually can't be transferred to a trust. So you need to go through it individual to each client, which assets should and should not go into the trust. Speak to your advisor about which assets should and should not go into your trust. I've spent almost 20 years helping clients plan their trusts, implement their trusts, and figure out which assets to transfer them to the trust and how to have those assets held by the trust. If you need help doing so, we can help you. Just contact us at info@esquiregroup.com or www.esquiregroup.com. Thank you.